Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Captain Skillet, and today it's a Let's Play. Can you guess what game this is? Yes, it's Alan Wake. It's a game I've been really wanting to play for a while, and of course it was on Steam for dirt cheap, so I said, hey, pick it up, why not? I happen to get all the DLC for it. Episodes here, see, look at that. You can choose, look at this, one, two, so I got a little bit of gameplay here to do. On top of new game, so it's extras, probably nothing. Options, graphics, audio, subtitles are enabled, that's all I need. Alright, so let's get to it. Easy or normal? You know what, I'm doing this for fun. Easy, fuck it. Haters gonna hate, why not normal? Because I want to play for fun. Oh, shh.
Nightmares exist outside of logic. And there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear.
Yeah.
In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end.
Kind of like the Dark Tower, huh, Steven?
I'm a writer.
Alan Wake.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards.
When your dream creeps the writer out, damn.
So yes, it began with a dream.
I have a dream.
Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late.
Uh-huh.
Desperately trying to reach
That's my nightmare too, to be late.
A lighthouse. For some urgent
reason, more my wife.
I couldn't remember.
Zing.
I've been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Oh, hit the hobo.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too.
Hitchhiker late. Hobo, same thing. Yeah, you. Look at that, you front grill. His damaged bumper's falling off. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he was.
I was convinced they put me in jail and I would never see out.
Unless you hide the body. Oh shit, car died. Now you're fucking walking with a corpse in the middle of the road. And it's gone. Yep.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Whoa. Yeah. Episode one, nightmare.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Let's get back in the car. Oh, wow. Sensitive mouse there. Look at the graphics. Not bad. Look up at the light. No, we are not going to invert. Wow, a little sensitive there. Sorry, one second. Controls. I got to turn down the sensitivity just a wee bit. There we go. WAZ to walk. Why aren't you getting back in the car? Shift to sprint. Sprinting time. Lighthouse.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me.
Oh, really? So I guess everything's in episodes? So I guess we'll do this on an episode basis? Oh. Hey, the hobo is back. Oh. Whoa. No, I'm getting off.
Think you're God. You think you can just make up stuff?
Yeah, I'm a writer.
People's lives and kill them if you think it adds to the drama.
I'm sorry, homie. I won't pull a George R.R. Martin. You can live in my next book.
Damn.
Really? I thought I dodged. Really? Where's this homie at?
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Oh shit. Now I think.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
I'm gonna make sure you die. after we escaped the giant tornado. Run, my friend. He's getting tired. Catch your breath. Now sprint. Come here, my friend. Running, run, run. Wow, I apparently just made it. Inside? Alright, homie. Trusting you. They got all weird filtery there. Dude, why didn't you get inside?
Oh no! Stop!
Shoot him!
No! Damn it, die! No!
Why do you only have two bullets in your revolver? Ow. I guess you could say he got axed. Oh, that's kind of freaky. Alright.
There was no way out.
Damn. What the fuck is that? That is terrifying. Open. That is so much for sleeping tonight. I am playing this like at 2:30 in the morning.
Had to get out.
Well, be a man. Push through this shit. Fuck yeah.
Follow the light.
Follow to the light? Yeah, I'm almost dead.
You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Safe in the light. Oh, it heals you. There you go. See, that's an interesting mechanic. Oh, the light's gone.
I have something important to tell you.
Tell me.
It goes like this.
God?
He did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been.
No.
Do you understand?
Not a fucking clue.
Follow my light.
You're just gonna rebuild the stairs? Well, he's God. He can do anything. Thank you, God.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now.
Oh.
When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The
okay.
Darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Burn! Purge the light. There you go.
You did it.
Now I can murder him?
It no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy.
Okay, he needs to die then.
Here, take the gun.
Now you'll die.
Boom, headshot. Tap R to reload. Well, that's nice.
Good. You've done well.
All right. Thank God.
That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Or you could stay.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world.
Yeah.
The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Let's get the ammo. Stock up. 42 shots. All right, homies. Really? What happened? That's what? Come on, bitches. I got enough for... Come on. I ain't afraid of you. I got a revolver. Pick up some bat. Oh, flare gun. I think I know what this does. If the flashlight destroys them, then I imagine.
Just like.
That will just destroy them. Yep. Awesome. So that's a save weapon. Because I only have two more shots. Later, homie.
You're dead. I can keep this up.
I got enough. Well, I don't have enough bullets. Alright. Running time. Oh, shit. Catch your breath, Alan. Catch your breath. Run, homie. Run to the lighthouse. But I think that tornado's right behind us. Yeah, catch your breath. You just survive your nightmares and a tornado. Make sure to kill that fucker off pretty good in the next novel. And this is his nightmare. Like, when I had a nightmare, like, I had a recurring nightmare. It was like Attack of the Giant Mutant Spider Ants from the old Choose Your novel. Oh, shit. And that was terrifying for me. But damn.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Oh, yeah? Where's here? On a boat thing. Raft. Bright Falls. See, this is just bad news. Fresh seafood, you better be fucking fresh. Triple D's, I don't know what that said. Alright. He has a nice car. Welcome to Bright Falls with a train. I still gotta say, this game's been out for a while and.
Let's act like we're on vacation.
Oh.
Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Alright.
Hi. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town.
I forgot what I was saying.
Just 2 weeks away.
Oh, graphics. Deerfest, huh? Look at this. Still pretty good. Speaking of Deerfest, I do have some veal chilling in the freezer. I might cook that up.
I'm Pat Mayne, by
the way. Hi, Pat. Nice to meet you, too.
I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself.
That's nice to know.
This isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Still a nice car.
Look, Mr. Mayne, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us.
Celebrities.
I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
I wonder how many people would actually, you know, keep to that promise. Like, how do we know he's not going to go talk to his homie and be like, man, fucking Alan Wake in town. Yeah, you get your pictures, bitch?
I got a couple of really good ones.
Oh.
So you made a friend.
She has a really nice jacket.
Right.
Alan actually has a really nice coat.
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer?
just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane.
I kind of want it. I'm trying to get a good view of it. It looks pretty dope. I like the whole jacket with a hoodie and a shirt.
So, how is the place? Has it got your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al.
Paint Jobs Garage. I think it's an auto shop. Smoke Fish Company. Storage and moving.
Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
Aw. So cute.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Turn the fucking phone
Barry
off then.
Is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
See? Oh, yeah.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you, too.
Oh, they have a Lincoln MKT. Man, I guess he is famous because that's
Come
a nice car.
Car.
What kind of junker is this? Washington. Damn, two hunting rifles. Fuck the car, bitch. I want to see what kind of truck this is. We're going to call it a Chevy.
Get the full service here.
And back to the film
we
grain.
We stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Oh, okay.
I'll go fill her up while you
Bright's Diner?
I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
How long do you think? Sync by Microsoft. I saw that.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
He's just getting the keys. Why does he need 15 minutes to get a key? Where is she going?
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns. Where
oh, well, they know who you, where you are now.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God. I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
He's like, bitch,
glad to hear that.
Give me my keys.
Rose.
I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey.
Stuckey.
Carl?
He must have gotten made fun of back in high school.
He'll be back in a moment.
Want to go take a shit?
I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Oh, so you're my stalker.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
It's like, yeah, kind of creepy. What the fuck is that?
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love. Because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black
right.
coffee under a thin
so
layer
much
of
for
skin.
Quiet vacation. Yeah, that makes two of us.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation
Ooh,
with
Thermos.
Wake.
Do me a favor, oh. Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut.
Yeah.
Number 6 in the jukebox.
Coconut?
I do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep.
Wake them bitches up, old-timer.
Bad circulation.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good...
Oh, Fonzie did.
What? Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
Alright.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Damn, like that, homie? Why is this lady just kind of... Let's find out. What's up?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
Oh, creepy music.
I wanted to find Stucky. To get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
I'm about to shit myself, aren't I?
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Man, who the fuck is... Oh, shit.
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in.
The fuck?
And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Which is kind of creepy.
Lake is a special place. very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
She knows something.
This really ought to be fixed. And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
She...
Even that
asleep.
Sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Put the coconut. Put it all up. Put the lime in the coconut and drink it all up. Oh yeah, I know this song.
Splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
Sorry, buddies.
The Andersons. They're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Oh. Alright. Well, deuces. I'm coming, bitch.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights.
Oh, thank God. We need them. That fucking creepy bitch is coming.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
The fuck?
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay.
You know, I considered writing a children's book. But,
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer. But that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years. Not since my last book.
Why? What happened with your last book? Oh shit. I recognize some of this part. Wow. A fucking cabin isolated on an island? I mean, you're not gonna have people bothering you, for fuck. Oh, I'm getting tired. Diver's Isle.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
Yeah.
Something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
Come on.
I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia.
Oh.
The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
She never got over being a kid then. Like, I guess some people are just terrified of it. I mean, it's, you know, dark. Hell, the hallway and I have to go out, it's freaking dark. And it gets creepy looking sometimes. Ticka ticka ticka. Daka daka daka. Come on, wife. Oh, well, I'm an ass. Well, I should have taken the bags. I've seen better in-game asses. Not bad either way. Okay, I guess that's better. Come on, let's get your dark, fearing ass in the cabin.
Let's take a look inside.
Open it.
Come on.
It's dark in there. Oh. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Hello? Anyone here?
I know laser collectibles. Upstairs? No? Oh, okay.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Oh, well, that was terrifying.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
Okay. Well, I pooped myself a little. Not gonna lie. What's up, radio?
The dear fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one of the
Is there a generator somewhere? Oh, out that way. Okay.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Yeah, I saw it. Shut up, woman.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Oh. Eh. There we go. Just like a lawnmower. Really? Alrighty then.
The lights are on.
That's good.
Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
The island sure had once been the site for a love story. Maybe
oh,
it would be that again.
That's how you can get cut off.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Aw, I blow a kiss. He's like, come on.
Happy
see you upstairs, darling. Yeah, you could. I do like the lighting effects. Pretty nice. Obviously, because it's a big portion component of the game. Well, it's not a bad cabin.
Alice? Honey?
How's this broad at?
Alan, I'm
upstairs. Aha, I knew it!
Have a
oh, yeah. Which room? I guess the. Uh-oh. Bow, chicka, bow, wow.
Well,
oh, goodness.
Hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
I feel you, man. I feel you, Alan. I'm getting all excited. Oh.
Surprise.
Yeah.
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past.
Damn, Alice, you. Everyone.
Hey,
keeps...
hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not...
Oh, shit.
Alan? Alan?
I don't. Just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
No, you shouldn't let your wife who's afraid of the dark alone. Thank God you have that flashlight.
Damn it. Alice?
Yeah, see?
Alice?
Go get your broad.
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alice! Alice! Where are you?
I'm coming. What's with all the crows?
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right. I'm coming.
What
no!
the hell?
Alan! Help me!
I'm coming, wife.
Alan!
Alice? Alice?
What the fuck? She fell into the water?
Oh, no.
Get in there, homie. Yep. In the water.
Keep going. Wake up.
What the hell?
Alice?
The hell?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another.
But I don't understand how you could have woken up in a car crash.
How I got there.
Yeah.
All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice.
Yeah.
The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
The hell?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Is there anything over here? No thermos? Wow, this guy barely lives. Well, a little bit of a safety net there.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Let's go, man.
Damn.
And there goes the car. No. So much for the Lincoln. It was a Lincoln, right? I don't know. Bad memories, bad memory. Going through the forest with no weapon. Feels like I'm playing Slender all over again. Oh, shit.
Hello?
Ah, really blinding.
Hello? Someone there?
Page? Shit, pages. Two of them.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Well, I guess I know what's happening. I'm gonna get attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night. Because I don't have my flashlight or bullets to put one in his brain. Yep, there he is.
Please, I've been in an accident.
I still have American Nightmare to play. Leave it in the comments below.
Good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down.
Let me know if it's a good, if it's even worth doing, bothering with. Up and over. Wait, I remember this part. Do I? I played on the Xbox before. I think I had issues here.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Hey!
It's not really the woods anymore.
There's been an accident. I need help.
Listen,
I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
What the hell?
To meet you. Non-refundable reservation deposit required. Fair and square.
What the fuck?
Fair and square.
Second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Exactly what I was thinking. Oh, look. A revolver and a flashlight by Energizer.
During your trying it's the latest in
testably.
Come on, homie.
Human help let you
kill
one stone. You can see the sights.
Yes.
And keep those cholesterol.
Great boy. Hello?
Oh, fuck my life.
This is bad.
Oh, wow. Yeah, what?
My head pounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
What the hell is the arrow pointing at? I think if I can turn these on. That sucks.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Oh, look, a secret.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Awesome. Flare gun. Use it when I need it. Okay, I kicked that, so I could use this to fight those idiots.
It's rabbit season.
I got a whole lot of ammo left. Oh, well, speak of the devil. Shit my pants again. I have to go wipe this time.
What the hell was that?
Yeah, I'm thinking the same thing. That game better stop it, because I'm running out of toilet paper. On top of the fact that I had Pizza Hut today, whew.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Well, good thing we're walking across this giant tree stump. Can you move that? I don't even know. Oh, coffee mug. Always gotta have time for coffee. I guess I'll die instantly if I try to cross the water. So we'll go this way. Any shadow demons? Get murdered. I ain't fucking around. I want my... Come on, Stucky.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Well, as soon as I get the flashlight on him, he's getting a bullet in his head. Oh, shit. Throw a freaking axe at me, bitch. Next time you guys get the flare. Let's climb up this bitch. Hopefully no one jumps me up here.
Taken. They're taken.
Batteries. You know what? Nice. Not really safe. I don't know if I want to play the whole episode. Alright. Alright. Drop down. Yeah. I'm going to call it here. Oh, well, I hope so. Anyway, this is the first part of my Let's Play Alan Wake series. Hope you enjoyed it. I gotta go wipe my ass. Bye.